This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book: The Darling Anton P. Chekhov's Portrait of Affection and Tragedy by Anton P. Chekhov. The Darling. Olenka, the daughter of the retired collegiate assessor Plemyanikov, was sitting on the back doorsteps of her house doing nothing. It was hot, the flies were nagging and teasing, and it was pleasant to think that it would soon be evening. Dark rain clouds were gathering from the east, wafting a breath of moisture every now and then. Kukin, who roomed in the wing of the same house, was standing in the yard looking up at the sky. He was the manager of the Tivoli, an open-air theater. "Again," he said despairingly. "Rain again. Rain, rain, rain. Every day rain. As though to spite me. I might as well stick my head into a noose and be done with it. It's ruining me. Heavy losses every day." He wrung his hands and continued, addressing Olenka, "What a life, Olga Semyonovna. It's enough to make a man weep. He works, he does his best, his very best, he tortures himself, he passes sleepless nights, he thinks and thinks and thinks how to do everything just right. And what's the result? He gives the public the best operetta, the very best pantomime, excellent artists. But do they want it? Have they the least appreciation of it? The public is rude. The public is a great bore. The public wants a circus, a lot of nonsense, a lot of stuff. And there's the weather. Look. Rain almost every evening. It began to rain on the 10th of May, and it's kept it up through the whole of June. It's simply awful. I can't get any audiences, and don't I have to pay rent? Don't I have to pay the actors?" The next day, towards evening, the clouds gathered again, and Kukin said with an hysterical laugh, "Oh, I don't care. Let it do its worst. Let it drown the whole theater, and me too. All right, no luck for me in this world or the next. Let the actors bring suit against me and drag me to court. What's the court? Why not Siberia at hard labor, or even the scaffold? Ah-ha-ha." It was the same on the third day. Olenka listened to Kukin seriously, in silence. Sometimes tears would rise to her eyes. At last Kukin's misfortune touched her. She fell in love with him. He was short, gaunt, with a yellow face and curly hair combed back from his forehead and a thin tenor voice. His features puckered all up when he spoke. Despair was ever inscribed on his face. And yet he awakened in Olenka a sincere, deep feeling. She was always loving somebody.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.